The HDMI forum announced a new version of the HDMI spec at CES this year. Jumping from HDMI 2.1 to 2.2 adds a couple of new features, a big jump in bandwidth between devices, and a new name, Ultra 96. The spec itself won't be released to partners who build devices and cables until later in the first half of 2025, so I don't expect to see any hardware using HDMI 2.2 for quite some time, which is fine by me. The top-level feature in HDMI 2.2 is a massive increase in bandwidth, the amount of data that devices can transfer between each other. The jump from 48 gigabits per second to 96 gigabits per second looks great on paper, but today's TVs don't need that bandwidth. HDMI 2.1b supports 8K 60 and 4K 120, no problem, with plenty of bandwidth left over for increased demands of the varied high dynamic range specs. So if HDMI 2.2 isn't for today's TVs, what is it for? The extra bandwidth is needed for virtual reality, industrial and medical displays, and other future tech, like light field displays. Like I said, you aren't going to need these cables for a minute. There's one new bullet point feature in HDMI 2.2 designed to help folks with complicated HDMI chains, typically involving either an AV receiver or a soundbar, manage their lip sync issues. The Latency Indication Protocol, aka LIP, provides full transparency about the audio and video latencies of different devices in the chain, which then gives the source device the ability to compensate for those differences when it outputs the signal. It's even able to adjust for different processing modes on the fly if you say, change your TV from film mode to a lower latency game mode. Of course, like all of the previous versions of HDMI, the new cables will be backwards compatible, so they'll work with all of your old devices even if they don't explicitly support HDMI 2.2. And like HDMI 2.1, the new spec includes a certification and labeling program to help cut down on mislabeled or counterfeit cables. Look for Ultra 96 certified cables when it's time to buy. And when will that be? Well, no hardware partners or devices have been announced yet, but I don't think it'll be anytime soon. In a few years, Ultra 96 HDMI cables will be cheap and plentiful, and you'll have 8K 240Hz displays in every room of the house that could actually use all that extra bandwidth. But until then, you can go on pretty much not worrying about HDMI 2.2.